Hello and welcome. I'm David, and in this episode of Assembly Language Basics, we'll be taking a look at the following commands. Okay, so I've got three LED displays set up here, with the first one representing the working register, the second representing a port or a memory register, and this last one will show us the result of a command. So we can label these working, port A, and result. Okay, so let's get cracking. Up first, ANDWF and LW. You should be familiar with the AND gate, but if you are not, it's pretty simple. If both inputs are high, then the output is low. If one or both inputs are low, then the output is low. Not much to it. ANDWF and ANDLW will take two values, AND those together, and store the result in the working register or in register F, depending on which command we are using. So if we take the value of F0 and AND that with 93 in hexadecimal, we'll get the result of 00010000. So basically what we've done is use one value to filter another value. Now you might think, what good is this? Well, let me show you. Let's say we've got a port on an MCU that's reading data from a number of external devices, and we just want the upper 4 bits of data while ignoring the lower 4 bits. We can accomplish this with just a few commands, but first, let's set our port to 10101001. Okay, so it's a little funny when I read out a number in binary. Okay, let's start by copying the value F0 into the working register with the command move LW 0xF0. Then we use the command ANDWF port A, W. This combines the two values using AND logic and stores the result in the working register. And as you can see, we ended up with only the upper 4 bits showing. Now, we have just the 4 bits we want, and we can go ahead and do whatever operations we need to do. But what if we want to use this value in a lookup table? We can't very well have that information in the upper nibble. We need it in the lower nibble. This is where a nifty command comes in that solves this problem, and that is swapf. Swapf will swap the upper and lower nibbles of a register and store the result back in that register or in the working register, depending on what we specify. If you remember, we stored the result of our last command in the working register. So the first thing we have to do is move that information into a temp register so we can use the command swapf. So let's rename our result display to temp and go ahead and move W into temp with the command move WF temp. Now that we have the data in the temp register, we can use the command swapf. And as you can see, the upper and lower nibbles have been swapped, and we can now work with the value with greater ease, especially when working with lookup tables. Okay, so we've read the port, filtered out the bits we don't want, and swapped the upper and lower nibbles. But what if we want to move the upper 4 bits of register temp into port A without affecting the lower 4 bits of port A? We could use a string of bitsetf, bitclearf, and bittestf, skipf, clear, and bittestf, skipf, set commands. But surely there's an easier way to accomplish this. Well, there is. And the command is called IORWF, which is an OR gate. So the goal here is to invert the upper nibble without affecting the lower nibble. Okay. Let's load the temp register with 0101001 with the commands move LW 01010101, move WF temp. Now, I've set the lower nibble of temp to a non-zero value to help illustrate this process. So now we have to make sure that the lower nibble in temp is zero. To do this, we'll use the ANDWF command. So we'll move LW 0xf0 and WF temp, F. So now we've filtered out the lower 4 bits while retaining the upper 4 bits. Next, we need to copy the lower 4 bits of port A into the working register with the commands movelw0x0f and wfportaw. And finally, we can use the iorwf command to bring the two values together. iorwf temp, w. So we've combined the lower nibble of port A with the upper nibble of temp and stored the result in the working register. And the very last step is to copy the contents of W into port A. Move WF port A. This sequence of commands accomplishes the goal of updating the upper four bits of port A while preserving the lower four bits. Now we accomplish the merge by using a total of six commands. And we also want to do this in such a way that the data on port A isn't changing until we are completely ready to change it. This prevents unwanted data changes on the port during the merger process. Okay, that's it for this assembly language basics video. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me. Take care and thanks for watching. And be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe.